All right, but so there's a couple of questions on how to get these rear breakdowns off of these Hudsons. And I think it's the same way as a lot of different old cars were back then. I had a, what was it, 53 Ford? Whatever I had. I forget now which one it was. Anyways, yeah, so you buy this puller on, you know, the Jungle website or somewhere else online. I want to say it was pretty cheap. I don't remember what it was, maybe 50, 60 bucks maybe? I really don't remember. So this is the kind of puller you want to have on here. All right. Obviously, I've already taken the cotter pin out and loosened the nut a little bit under here, so it's loose. And then this is, I think it's called a dog bone pulling tool, maybe. I think it's called that. And this bad boy right here, we just tighten this down. Now, I've had this brake drum off already, so it's not going to be like when I first took it off, the first time I did this. I beat the snot out of it with the Tanya Harding here, and it didn't come off for a while. So I took someone's advice, like let it sit overnight, come back and did it some more, got a couple more threads out of it, come back later on, did it some more, and it worked. So this one should pop right off, I would think, because like I said, I've had it off before. Still loose in here. I feel like the washer is still moving, so it's not hadn't popped out quite yet. Oop! I hate that. That sounded like it popped it. Yeah, that sounded like it did it. Let's see here. I actually heard there's an audible pop. Yeah, yep, yeah, it's loose now. So, okay, so that's basically it. There's actually an audible pop. Loosen all this stuff up here and pull it off. It's going to take a little bit of work because the reason I'm taking this off right now is because my brake was frozen up. So, and it's leaking in the back. So I'm going to probably mess with it a little bit, but that's all it really is to it. Like I said, some guys say that you should let it sit overnight so you're not, you know, exploding out, and don't sit in front of it like I am. So that way it does pop off. It doesn't kill you. But I didn't care about that. So anyways, that's all there is to it, guys. It's pretty easy, but it's the tool, right? Get the tool, right tools, make the good job, the job much easier. It was relatively inexpensive, and it came like a couple days on Amazon there. So, all right. Well, I thought I'd add this to the end of the video. I think there's some guys asking about brakes on it too. So this is the rear brakes, how they're set up. Obviously, I have new hardware on here. My brake was frozen up for some reason. I had these my shoes repadded at a local place that repads them. Serious wear in here. The drum wasn't great, but I thought I could get away with just getting new shoes. But if you look right, yeah, she broke, so they didn't hold up. Not really sure why that happened, but it did. Maybe it's because I didn't clean this in here. I'm thinking it's what it is. It's gross and nasty, and it's not clean, so that's probably why it failed. But yeah, this is what they look like. I got little retainer clips here. I got these are all new. Springs are new. I didn't get a new. I didn't buy new cylinders, but I rehoned these, and they seem to be working fine. I actually have some of those now, so maybe I'll just replace it. I don't think it's stuck out, and the adjustment's all the way in for this one. So not really sure what the deal is with this, but that's what they look like when they're put together. Yeah. All right.